In this demo, we are going to look at reporting the promoting interoperability category and the requirements associated. From here, on the overview page, we have the ability to go down and look at all of our practices that were associated, as well as any type of special statuses or criteria that might be associated with the different groups. For this specific group, you can see that they're listed as non-patient facing. For groups that are listed as non-patient facing, they are automatically exempt from reporting the promoting interoperability category. Once I go into report as group, we can see that the promoting interoperability category is listed as NA in the overall score. And within the category card, you can see that there's NA listed at the top, as well as the fact that this category counts for 0% of your score. For groups that wish to report PI that have an exemption, there is the ability to do that. The first item that you can do is create a manual entry. You'll be presented with a prompt letting you know that your current category weights will be shifted by proceeding forward. This would only be in the instance that you do wish to offset your current reweighting category and be scored for the promoting interoperability category. Clicking on Yes, I agree, then continue. I'm now able to report for this category. For those that wish to create a manual entry, you have the ability to click on Create Manual Entry. This will take you through a stepwise submission where each piece is required to be reported prior to proceeding to the next step. The first item that must be entered is the performance period. When entering the performance period, it's very important to note that you are required to report on at least 90 days for the category. If you report on a time period that is less than 90 days, you will receive notification that 90 days is required and the result of this submission will be a score of 0 for the category and you will not receive any credit. Going to modify our date range to accommodate the 90-day period. And you can see that that modal has now gone away. And the next step will be to enter your cert ID. If you have questions around your cert ID or which cert you are using, you can go to the qpp.cms.gov resource library, or you can go to the CMS Chapel website to look up your EHR product and which ID is correlating to the product you're using. Once I've entered in my cert ID, you can see that I'm now able to enter in my attestation statements. For a quick review, if we go back to the reporting overview page, where we were initially listed as NA for promoting interoperability, you can see this category does now have a weight. You can see that on the card itself, it's showing that it's out of 25 and that the percentage is 25% of your score. So we're going to go back in and complete our manual entry. The first two attestation statements are required underneath of the PI category. And if you do not either complete them or attest yes, then you will receive a score of 0 for the category. The first item that we have is ONC direct review, that you will participate in good faith with ONC underneath of a direct review request from ONC. The second item that we have is the prevention of information blocking, saying that you are not intentionally limiting information to be shared, in which case we're going to click that we are not knowingly doing so. And the last item is the ONC surveillance attestation that if there is any type of request from ONC that you will cooperate in good faith This is optional and not required. We're going to click yes. The first measure associated with PI is the e-prescribing measure. This is for practitioners that write enough prescriptions and utilize the EHR to transmit the prescription, as opposed to a paper prescription being given to the patient. There is an exclusion with this that any MIPS eligible clinician who writes fewer than 100 permissible prescriptions can be excluded from this category. We are going to actually go through and enter in our information here. For any of the measures where a numerator denominator is required, you'll see a note that pops up once you enter in the information for the numerator, letting you know that the proportion valued is not yet valid, so it will not be saved. In this instance, you must report a denominator that is either greater than or equal to the numerator to proceed. You can see once I've entered in this information, the prompt has gone away and is showing me that the measure has been completed. A secondary item underneath of the e-prescribing is the bonus for the query of the prescription drug monitoring program. If you've participated within this program, you have the ability to attest that you have done so by clicking on yes. This will give you a 10-point bonus for the PI category. Health information exchange is required to either go down two different options, either one, performing both HIE1 and HIE4, which would be the referral support electronic referral loops by sending health information, and then support electronic health referral loops by receiving and reconciling health information. The second option is the health information bidirectional exchange, which means that you are both sending and receiving information within your EHR for the patients that you are seeing. Again, with the numerator denominator, it goes with the same type of standard as above, that you must enter in a denominator that is greater than or equal to the numerator information being entered. If you were doing option one, then both HIE1 and HIE4 are both required. The next item we have is providing patients electronic access to their health information. This would be a portal available for any of their patients to view their charts that are associated within the EHR. And then this is looking to see how many of the patients actually access the information. Security risk analysis is making sure that your patient portal has been secured to meet all of the security standards associated with housing any type of PII or PHI information. The last category that we have within PI is the public health and clinical data exchange. Underneath it here, you can see that we have multiple categories for which the registry is associated. If you are reporting to a specific registry and have reported to multiple registries underneath of the type, you have the ability to report on the measure more than once. Let's say for this practice, they have reported to two separate immunization registries. So the first item that they're going to do is click on yes to indicate that they have reported to the first one. And from here, you can see that we have the ability to click on report measure again. Once we have done that, you can see that there's a dropdown that is now available for us to say that we are reporting to more than one immunization registry in accordance with the measure specifications. Once we've clicked on this, you can see that we have now completed our PI category submission, and we can view our preliminary score. Once completed with this, we can go back to the group reporting overview page. We can see that our PI score has now registered and is available. And from here, you can go on to complete your QPP reporting for the other categories, either quality or IA, by either one, going in and creating a manual entry for IA, or two, going into quality and reporting via an upload utilizing either MIPS CQMs or ECQMs that are supported within the program.